shared Holy Communion. And this past summer, I had the privilege to go on the youth pilgrimage with this group to Italy. And we are really excited to share about our time on the pilgrimage with y'all. We had some really awesome experiences as a group and individually. And I am so excited for them to get to just share that with y'all, because there's some fun stories and moments. And throughout the time in Italy, we are really focusing on kind of looking for those like thin places that appear usually when we're not expecting them. And so I'm excited for them to get to share a little bit about that. And then, of course, some funny stories and stuff in the mix. So I'm going to pass the mic off and let the group introduce themselves, and then we'll go from there.
Hello, my name is Smith Sulzer. I go to St. Benedict at Armordale, and I am in 11th grade, and my Jesus moment was St. Peter's Basilica.
I'm Ketcher Miller. I go to MUS. I'm in the 11th grade, and my Jesus moment was probably just the Vatican and being with the Pope.
I'm Harrison Guest. I'm a junior at MUS, and my Jesus moment was seeing the dedication people put into building the churches.
I'm Xander Mathis. I'm in 11th grade at MUS, and my favorite moment was the pasta making class.
I'm Josie Block. I'm a junior at St. Mary's, and one of my favorite moments was getting to see all the artwork.
I'm Lacey Farrell. I'm also a junior at St. Mary's, and my favorite moment was our last night as a whole group.
I'm Corinne Cowan. I go to St. George's, and I'm a sophomore, and my favorite moment was walking around Florence.
I'm Allie Mari. I'm a junior at White Station, and my favorite moment was the catacombs.
I'm Charlie Bragg. I'm a sophomore at MUS, and my Jesus moment was at St. Peter's Basilica.
Michael Yarbrough, good at MUS. My Jesus moment was the service at the Anglican Center.
I'm Stanton Miller. I'm a sophomore at MUS, and my Jesus moment was all the statues and art we saw.
Hi, I'm Marshall McGahey, and I go to Baylor School in Chattanooga.
All right, so I'm just going to give a kind of a quick overview of what we did on our pilgrimage and where we traveled to. So we went from Memphis to Rome, and then we spent 2 days in Rome, and then we drove to Assisi, and we spent a day and a night in Assisi, and then we traveled to Florence, where we spent 2 days in Florence and came home. Just to give another kind of portion of the overview and some just maybe some things that you might hear in the presentation that would be good to know. So some highlights would be the name Massimo. He was our guide. We loved Massimo very much. So if you hear that name, that's who that is. We did experience a COVID situation with our group. So if you hear reference there, where you will hear more about that in the pilgrimage. But some people's trips were a little longer and shorter than others. And so if you hear reference to that, that's what that was. So we as a group kind of decided that the way we wanted to present our trip was by going through our highlights of the trip and then including some honorable mentions and then some things that kind of made our pilgrimage special to our group. So we'll go through landmarks, our favorite sites in Florence, favorite group moments, our time in Assisi, the Vatican, a pasta class we got to do, the churches we visited, and then some honorable mentions, and then a few things that kind of made our pilgrimage special. So I'm going to pass it off to Harrison to start off with landmarks.
Hi, I'm Harrison. I'm going to be discussing the landmarks that we saw. First is the Colosseum. On our tour of ancient Rome, we visited the Colosseum, a massive arena built by Vespasian, a Roman emperor, ranking it in one of the largest structures of ancient Rome. It could hold 50,000 spectators who could watch gladiator games and even naval battles. Composed of a series of arches, the massive arena provided a unique view in a Roman architecture and gave a great view of the city. As someone who studied Latin for 3 years, it was fascinating to see the buildings of the history that I had studied. Next is the Trevi Fountain. Located in Rome, the Trevi Fountain was built in the 18th century. Legend says that if you throw a coin over your shoulder into the fountain, you will be destined to return to Rome. Around the plaza containing the fountain were many small shops, mainly gelato shops, cafes, and tourist traps. The place was a massive tourist destination, as people of all nations were there. It was interesting to see how they interacted with the sites. Following is the catacombs. Looking outside the old walls of Rome, the catacombs are the resting place of many Christians persecuted by the Roman emperor for their beliefs, and then several popes are also buried there. Walking through the damp passages, one could place himself in the shoes of the early Christians who were persecuted for their beliefs. The Spanish Steps is the final one I'm going to cover. In Rome, a massive set of stairs is built into the city. After a long, steep hike to the top, it provides a great view of the skyline of Rome. And this, we've ended our first day there. It was a great place to end it. We did learn a valuable lesson that even though the street vendors may say something is free, it's not free. They will charge you for it. Next are Allie and Josie.
Okay, so we're going to be talking about our favorite sites in Florence. And so just one thing we noticed about Florence when we first got there is that as opposed to Rome, it was a lot more of a Renaissance city, and Rome was a lot more like ancient. And so that's something cool we noticed. So everything was a lot different from what we had already seen. And it was touristy, but it was not as much. So
the one of the most interestings that we saw was David by Michelangelo. And once we got through the kind of museum part where they had a lot of other paintings, we walked into this big room where David was. And it was really interesting. You could walk around like 360 and see all angles of the statue. And it actually used to be in the main plaza of Florence, but now they have a fake one like in the plaza because the real one kept getting vandalized. So that was interesting.
Next, we went to the Duomo, and that's like the big dome, or also the Florence Cathedral. And it's right like in the center of Florence. And it's also, the dome is the tallest point in Florence, and they build all the rest of their buildings lower so that it will still be the tallest point. And it was really interesting to see because it was the first big dome. And then Ghiberti's doors were on the baptistry, and they're very detailed. And we had a lot of fun looking at those. And then also, on our last day, we went to the Michelangelo Plaza, and it was like the last thing we did as a group. And it is this platform that overlooks the whole city of Florence. And there were like street vendors and a really beautiful view, and we got some good pictures. And our guide, Massimo, actually didn't tell us where we were going. He wanted it to be a final surprise. So that was really cool. And yeah, that's what it looked like.
And after some of us tested positive for COVID, we were looking for things to do that would be kind of like safe for people around us, but we didn't have to be in the hotel room all the time. So one of the things we did was we visited the Rose Gardens, which is like, it's exactly what it sounds like. It's a rose garden, and it's free for entry, and it had really gorgeous views of Florence, and it was kind of similar to the ones from the Michelangelo Plaza. And it was just really amazing, and it was fun to do in a not so fun situation.
And now we're going to hand off the mic to Corinne and Richard to talk about group moments.
Good morning. I'm Richard.
And I'm Corinne.
And we're happy to be here. You can see the generational differences. I have written down and need readers to see what is in front of me. Everyone else is using technology. But having worked for a paper company, I do appreciate a little bit of paper. We wanted to talk a bit about the group experiences. And when we were preparing for the presentation, there were a series of questions that Carter presented to the group. And you heard them respond to one of those questions. You know, what was a Jesus moment? Another one of those questions was, why is this pilgrimage important to Church of the Holy Communion? Why is it important that we as a parish support this pilgrimage? And I think you were starting to see some of that. You've seen it and heard it in past presentations. There is a legacy that has been built. And this is part of that program, that when you come to Church of the Holy Communion, or if you even know about Church of the Holy Communion, this is an opportunity for you to grow spiritually, to grow friendships, and to see things that you might not otherwise see. So we're going to talk a little bit about what some of those experiences look like for us as a group. The first one is Compline, which, as we know, is end-of-day service. This was done at a variety of places. It was done in parks. It was done in the courtyards of hotel rooms. It was done on a rooftop because, as you've heard from COVID, we needed to maintain 6 feet of distance, and the rooftop offered that there on our last night while everybody was still together. But it was also a chance for each one of the youth to officiate, so they each kind of had a leadership role in that. And it also gave us an opportunity to talk about the Jump Joy Jesus moments that we experienced in that day.
Mm-hmm. So as Richard said, one of the places that we had Compline was on the balcony, which is outside our hotel in Florence. And it connected a lot of the rooms that we had through our windows. So we climbed out the windows to get onto the balcony. And even though COVID split us up, we were still able to have one last social distance chapel together on our last night in Italy. We didn't just use it for Compline, we also used it just to hang out at a safe distance from our COVID friends.
You know, some of the other experiences, whether it be the hotels, things of that nature, there were a few of us. So, Corinne, as you can probably gather, she and I were part of the group that had an opportunity to do Pilgrimage 2.0. We also had Jonathan, who got to know the hotel room in Assisi quite well. For several weeks, and he'll speak about his experience there. But the hotel also offered an opportunity for us to gather at the end of the day. I think there were some pretty vicious Monopoly games played and some other activities that just kind of brought us together in an opportunity where phones were not permitted. And this is interesting. We talk about technology. This was not a decision that, you know, Carter and team said, this is what we're going to do. There was input. Input from the youth, input from parents to say, in this day and age, do we want to allow the phones or do we want to keep them back home? So the phones stayed back, and there weren't those distractions that often do keep us away from one another in a virtual sense.
And so another bonding experience that we had, well, we had no phones, was driving around the bus, which was driven by our favorite bus driver, Tommy, a friend of Massimo, and we really bonded on the trips from Rome to Assisi and Assisi to Florence, and we told lots of stories and we chatted with each other. Another bonding experience was walking around the cities. We mostly took the bus in between cities, and we did a lot of walking around the cities, so it was a really great, we spent a lot of time walking in Italy, and it was a really nice time to bond with our fellow pilgrims. So now we're going to pass the mic off to Stanton and Jonathan.
I'm Stanton.
I'm Jonathan.
In contrast to Italy and Florence, Assisi was very not crowded, and it was kind of in the countryside, only an hour away from Rome. There was
pretty big plaza and like three churches,
which were all very, very nice churches. One of them was a former Roman temple and now is a Christian church. There were lots of food, lots of stores, lots of lavender shops. Kind of odd. And then, yeah, that's all I have.
Some of y'all may have heard, I had an extended stay at Assisi in the hotel room. I spent more time than the rest of the pilgrimage there, but I wouldn't say that I saw more of Assisi. I was confined to my room with a positive COVID test, unfortunately. But I did have a lot of time to think, in addition to trying to translate the Italian Health Ministry's website. It sort of struck me that Assisi was the first day and a half, the first couple days in Rome were very busy. It's a big city. There's people everywhere. And while we were, of course, practicing the pilgrimage practices of walking and talking and sharing Compline and reflection in the evenings, it felt a little more like a trip we might take as individuals just to see the sights. And But as we kind of got to spend some time in St. Peter's Basilica, in the catacombs, which were just those sort of spaces that are thick with generations of prayers that you can almost feel in the air, like some of us may feel at our home church of Holy Communion or other holy places, I think we began to slow down a little bit. And as we took the bus up to Assisi and walked through its sort of medieval streets, we kind of had a chance, I think, to take a breath a little bit. And since you're not allowed to take pictures in the holy sites, we got to kind of soak in the basilica. A little ironic for a man who is almost most well known, besides animals, for his commitment to holy poverty, that then a giant, beautiful basilica was built in his remembrance. But, he clearly, St. Francis is, and St. Clare top the list, or are on the short list of, I think, saints that seem to have had the widest impact and caught the imaginations of so many people around the world. And so it drew pilgrims from all over. But we also saw there was a shrine in one of the local churches to one of the newest saints that the Roman Catholic Church has declared. If y'all remember, there's a boy who either has just been sanctified or is in the process of sanctification. Process? Thanks. It was because of his evangelism. Do you remember, Stan, the little bit of his story?
Not really. He did some miracles, I think.
He evangelized over the internet. So he's the first. Yeah. He's the first kind of digital saint. At least that's what the Rome's promotional materials are sort of telling it. But a young man who clearly loved the church and loved Jesus very much, and died young. I believe it was due to cancer. But is being lifted up as a saint of God, and that was happening in this same place that was celebrating a saint of 500 or 600 years ago. And so this sort of, it was this nexus point of old world and new world, and of God's church and God's people still active in the world, and that kind of felt like a unique thing about Assisi. Anything else to add?
We're going to pass it on to Ali and Corinne.
One of my God moments was getting to experience St. Peter's Basilica. I adored the basilica, and I loved getting to see so much history in one building. For me, it was like God was present in the room, and that isn't something that I feel very often. And I loved getting to experience this with all the other pilgrims. It was so fun to see the basilica and to see all of the beautiful artwork in it, and getting to experience God together in that space.
So like Marshall said, it was St. Peter's Basilica was really pretty. It was gorgeous. And one of the things that I noticed is that there were kind of statues of a bunch of saints everywhere, and something about the statues told you about the life of that saint. And there were a bunch of mosaics and murals, and it was really cool.
So within St. Peter's Basilica, there's a structure in the middle. It's called the baldachin. You can see it in the upper left photo, I think. And it's actually really big, but it looks so small because St. Peter's Basilica is massive. And the columns are designed after the Temple of Solomon, which was taken, I believe, from Jerusalem by Emperor Constantine. And it marks the tomb of St. Peter, which is below it.
So one of the things that we did after we got done kind of touring the main area of St. Peter's was we went under it, and we went to the papal crypts. And it was really interesting because it had basically all the previous popes that are buried there. And I thought it was really interesting to see kind of where all the popes were buried.
In addition to seeing where all the popes are buried, one of the things I thought was really interesting was off one of the main rooms in St. Peter's Basilica, there was an engraved list on the wall which listed every single pope all the way back to St. Peter's. And I just thought it was really interesting to see the continuation of Christianity and how far we've gone.
Another interesting thing that we did after we were done touring, you know, the papal crypts, the main part, was we sent letters from the Vatican. And it was kind of fun because I think you can see a picture of Stanton sending one on the bottom right. Anyways, that was really fun because we didn't get the Italian stamps. We got specifically the Vatican stamps, which was kind of cool. And I think, and it was fun for our families to open. I actually got to see my parents' reaction because I didn't get to my house until we got back. So. So while we were at the Vatican, we went to the papal blessing, which it was really interesting because we gathered in the main area and we got to see the Pope drive by in his Pope mobile, and he usually would have walked, I think, but he was having knee problems. But anyways, the blessing was cool because it was done in a ton of different languages because people come all over to get the papal blessing. And I think it was really cool because it's the Pope, like, kind of blessing. It was kind of a direct line to Jesus because Jesus blessed St. Peter, who blessed, I guess, the first Pope. And the line just kind of continues down, and it goes back to us. So the Pope blessing us was really the most direct line we have, and I thought that was really special.
So after we went to the papal blessing, we went to the Vatican Museum, which, aside from the main show of the Sistine Chapel, there are just dozens and dozens of rooms filled with beautiful mosaics and murals. And so after you pass through all the tons of beautiful rooms, the space opens up into the Sistine Chapel. And it's very dark, and no photos are allowed, so Josie photoshopped, as you might have guessed, that photo there. But it was really a God moment for a lot of us to see how many people were there craning their necks up to see Michelangelo's paintings. Yeah. And now we're going to pass the mic to Ketcher, Xander, and Smith.
Hey, I'm Smith.
I'm Xander.
I'm Ketcher.
Well, we went to a pasta making class on the third day in Rome, and to get there, we got to walk through like the most picturesque Italian alleys and neighborhoods. I thought that was really cool. And then once we got there, we got separated into two groups. One got to roll out, make the pasta, and then the other group got to make the meat sauce, bruschetta. I think also worked on a dessert, and then ended up being the best meal we had there. It was just really fun to sit as a group. I ate the food we made. And
all right, so the food we probably ate the most would be pizza. We had it probably every day. So I'm going to go through and rank the cities by the quality of their pizza. So number one was probably Florence. It had very high quality pizza. I enjoyed it. And then followed by Florence is Rome. Rome had above average pizza. It wasn't quite Florence level, but. And then disappointingly, Assisi had subpar pizza. It was a small sample size. We only ate at one place, but it seemed like it was microwave pizza. So they get last.
By the time Assisi rolled around, I've always had like pasta and pizza. I was like, you know what? Got branch out a little. So when I went to lunch in Assisi, I ended up seeing a lamb chop on the menu, and I was like, oh, sweet, I'm going to get that. Ended up being like a really good lamb chop. And in Florence, we had a girls' lunch, and we sat down at this place. I saw a filet that was only 25 euro. I got a shirt that was 2 euro more, and I was like, you know what? This filet is cheap. I'm going to get it. And then our last day for lunch, I saw a burger on the menu that was only 15 euro, and the steak that they had there was 60 euro. So I was like, yeah, I don't have 60 euro, so I'm just going to get a burger, deal with it. They put a steak as the burger patty, instead of the usual ground beef patty that they usually put in here in burgers. So I was like, huh, I got a deal, sweet deal. So yeah, we're gonna pass it off to Josie and Michael now.
Okay, so we're gonna be talking about all the churches that we visited.
The churches were some special places that we went, and like really thin places for all of us. It was coolest to see that all churches did like all the same things we do in our churches here. So yeah.
So the first place we went was the Anglican Center, and it's in Rome. And they actually let us participate in the service by letting us do the readings. So a few of us got to go read and say the prayers of the people. And we also met the Reverend or Bishop Eddington, who's in charge of the Episcopal churches in Europe. And he was there. And he's actually, I think, been to Memphis in Holy Communion before. But it was really cool because we got to talk to him and just, yeah, but it was also very similar to a service that would be at Holy Communion. And that was really cool to see that we could go halfway around the world and it would still be something that we are comfortable with and something we knew.
St. Paul's Within the Walls was the first Protestant church to be like built, established inside the walls of Rome, because Europe had been Catholic-centered for like hundreds, if not like 1,000 years at that time. So it's pretty big. The walls of the church were depicted with many like images of saints, and mosaics, things like that. This is the first Episcopalian church we had been to on our pilgrimage, I think.
Yeah, it was.
Okay.
The Anglican Center is run through the Church of England, so similar, but this was ours under Bishop Eddington's auspices. You're right.
Okay. The church in the basement, they have a refugee-like area. They take in a lot of people. I think they've taken a lot of people from Ukraine recently. So that was nice to see. And Ali Liz in prayer in their garden to finish us off there.
And then the last church is St. John's, and it's in Florence. And we went to just Sunday church, and it was the last day of our trip, and we ended up actually walking in the middle of the sermon because the testing center didn't go as planned before, so we were a little late. And we got a few looks, but then we sat down, and it was really nice. It was a nice service. And they had it in both Italian and English, so everyone could understand. And it was nice to just go to church on a Sunday like usual and pray. And after the service, we actually got to go talk to the priest, and he showed us around and gave us a little tour of the gardens. And they have like a pet cemetery, and he showed us their side chapel. And we also got a chance to speak with some of the people who go to church there, and it was really cool to talk to them. So now we're going to hand off the mic to Lacey and Charlie to talk about the honorable mentions.
So we're going to start off with the testing center. It was a farm. I'm Lacey, by the way. I'm so sorry.
I'm Charlie.
The testing center was a pharmacy similar to our type of Walgreens in Florence that we went to on our last official day to get our COVID tests. This test itself went well as a COVID test can go, but three of the pilgrims, Charlie, Allie, and I, were positive, along with one of our chaperones, Richard. And Jonathan had already been tested and was in Assisi. It was probably like the best and worst parts of our trip.
Yeah, so the testing center was one of the best and worst parts of our trip, because, you know, we got the terrible news on the last day of Florence. We're separated from the rest of our group all alone, and we were scared, we didn't know what was going to happen. But it wasn't all bad. On the last day in Italy, we ended up seeing a parade go by for this like weird rugby wrestling game they have every year. I don't know, they had like knights walking around the street, people dancing. So that was cool to see, but overall, the testing center is kind of a place of mixed feelings. Because
we saw the parade go by as we got our negative results that we got to go home.
Yeah.
So it was
yeah.
crazy moment. Mm-hmm. Then Mazamo, our tour guide. We first met him when we arrived in Rome. And he picked us up, and from that moment forward, he went out of his way to make sure our trip was the best it could possibly be. He helped us find restaurants, helped with our COVID needs, find the best view for our tours, and everyone loved getting to know him. Sometimes he would even order for us in restaurants to make sure we got the best meal.
Yeah, Massimo, he was definitely kept us all together. He would protect us from dangerous people, and it wouldn't have been the same without him. You could tell he really cared about us. On the day the three of us got tested positive, he didn't care that we had COVID. He came and gave us all a hug, and he was all sad and to see us go. And him and his little henchman Tommy, who drove us around Italy, really made the trip a better experience, and it wouldn't have been the same without him.
Last is the gelato. There are so many different gelato places that we all loved, and they were very good. Everyone's favorites were very different. And you could find places all over Italy, and there was like more than you could expect. There was one that the COVID group really, really loved in Florence, and we were lucky that we were able to go quite a bit. And we learned from our tour guide that it was considered by locals and tourists to be like the best gelato in Florence. And we agreed. Yeah. Well, we have like some of the favorites. Do you want to talk?
Oh, yeah. They had all kinds of gelato, like chocolate, s'mores, banana. That was my favorite. And hazelnut. I mean, everything you could think of. Overall, the gelato places were basically a place where we could, it's very hot in Italy. It was basically a place where we could rest. And it was probably the place where our group connected the most and got to know each other. And I mean, they're everywhere, probably every like 30 feet, you'll see one. And like Lacey said, our one tour guard named Bernardo recommended this like authentic gelato place that I guess it was like a local spot. We went there over the course of our little vacation. And when we had COVID. And so, yeah, they were just a good place to connect and really define the experience of Italy.
Now passing it off to Carter and Marshall.
All right, so y'all have heard from Marshall a few times who was, she is in boarding school in Baylor, so she wasn't able to be with us presently this morning, but she has been able to participate virtually a few different ways. But I did just want to talk about, I think Richard has, everyone's kind of mentioned a few of these like moments that make the pilgrimage special. And the things that I'm going to talk about are things that have been a part of the Holy Communion pilgrimage before any of us were a part of the Holy Communion pilgrimage, which just makes it even more special, I think. And so two things that we incorporate are journaling, and that is something each of the pilgrims and adults got a journal before we left Memphis as a way to really, we say, use it for what you want, but at least, at the end of the day, write down what we did that day and what you ate. That we did so much in a day that usually I would even be like, where do we even start, And so just for that reason, and then from there, whatever kind of reflections or moments is just a keepsake. And I think I know other past pilgrimage adults and youth, that's something that it's just nice to hold on to. And then, and I think that if you pilgrims have left theirs over on that table, if you want to look at it, of course there are some, more like personal pages. So just use it as something to look at, but I think they would appreciate if you didn't like read every word. And then another part of the pilgrimage that we have also kind of inherited from past groups that we think is really special is that on the last night, each member of the group is tasked with writing a letter to everyone else in the group, so that when we get home, everyone received a handful of letters and everyone was given a handful of letters, essentially. And so we wrote those on the airplanes, like you saw in the pictures, and the airports. But a special part for our group was that we were getting home kind of at different times, you know. So I think some of y'all got to get like a few extra letters like after you got home. And so it's kind of a neat one of thing just to kind of reminders. And I'm sure we could all go around and say, like, you know, where we keep those as a special place for us. Mine are in my office as a reminder. And so I think that these are just things that kind of make our group a little special and closer. And so I'm actually going to read the letter that Marshall wrote to y'all as an example of kind of what we would write to each other, and just because everyone got one and y'all deserve a letter as well. So, dear parishioners of Church of the Holy Communion, thank you so much for helping the pilgrims take part in this multi-generational experience. We are all so thankful that we got to be a part of such a special Holy Communion tradition. Knowing that the congregation was thinking of and praying for us was the most special feeling. The pilgrimage truly changed my life, and I know that the other pilgrims can say the same. Standing in the Sistine Chapel with my fellow pilgrims, knowing that thousands of miles away, we had the support of the congregation was the most special feeling. We felt your prayers in the trying and joyous moments, and through those prayers, we were able to strengthen our relationship with God. One of my favorite memories from the trip was a church service we attended on our last day. That was at St. John's that Josie was talking about. We were in Florence, and getting to be in the church service like what Holy Communion would be having the very next day was so special. The trip showed me how universal the Episcopal Church really is and how far the hand of God reaches. Being a pilgrim has made me a better person, Christian, and parishioner of Holy Communion, and I am forever grateful for the prayers and contributions from the church. Peace and love, Marshall McGahee. So that was sweet. And Smith, if you would. And then we were very tired a lot of times. I'm gonna ask Josie to come up. Josie Block has worked, so one second. Before, the pilgrims, like they mentioned, they did not bring their phones on the trip. So that became a question of, well, how do we take photos? So they all, most came with some sort of digital camera, which was really fun because I didn't even think about this beforehand, but nobody carries digital cameras around anymore. So it was just like them and everyone else had their iPhones and they're like clicking away in the like silent Sistine Chapel. But just a funny side note. Anyways, so because of that, Josie used her camera to make a vlog of our trip, which we are going to share with you. It has a lot of raw footage of the trip. So I think that you will watch this and really feel like you were there. And I think it's a fun way to just kind of get to experience the trip along with us. So if you would like to say anything else, Josie. It's really amazing, and thank you for putting this together. It's truly great.
So using my digital camera, I made this video of us all together in Italy. And if you've never heard of a vlog, it's a video blog. So it's just from my point of view, and I hope you enjoy it. It's a lot of just, like, goofy moments in us, like, being together. And I'm also going to read the intro because it goes kind of fast, so.
It is the summer of the year 2022, and 15 pilgrims have been set with the task of experiencing Rome, Assisi, and Florence in order to grow in their Episcopal faiths. Carter, Richard, and Jonathan fearlessly lead the pilgrims through with the help of our trusty guide Massimo and bus driver Tommy. The pilgrims see and experience so much, and they cannot wait for viewers to get a glimpse into these wonderful 8 days.
Even though we're not in Italy yet. Yeah. So we're in the airport, and men,
there's Lacey and Allie. We're still in the airport.
What did we do? We just met Taylor Jenkins.
Yes, we did.
Interrupted a bunch of the new boys. Yeah, still in the airport. It's currently 11:28.
There's the boys. We were asking them if they wash their face.
3 out of 6. Yeah, 3 out of 6 of them wash their face. That's pretty good.
Yeah, how do I zoom this in? How do I do this? Zoom. I don't even know. How do I zoom it in? Oh, wait. Oh, there we go. There we go, it's going.
It's good.
It's good? How is it, Marshall?
I'm gonna be honest.
Here, let me. Lava get is
better.
Let me.
Can I still buy that? Oh, sure.
Lacey, how is it?
It's only for songs, everybody.
I feel
better.
It's not bad.
Basically, we're
in Italy now.
Yeah. We've been in these clothes like hours.
Say hi. Harrison, say hi.
Try it, Josie.
I'll try it, okay.
You know, other than there's a dog.
Yeah, it does.
It's just like strong, a family. It's good. It's like really sweet. Is it good?
Yeah. It's like a little different, but not much.
Yeah. Bye, vlog.
Vlog.
Yeah. Okay, guys, so we got some free time. Vlog. So, this is us. We're a little dusty today, but these are the views. Yeah, smile. Say hi to vlog. This is vlog. This is Pantheon. People are everywhere. Peace. Hey guys, here we are. 30,000. We just ate lunch.
Here, we have our pity.
Yeah, Marshall, you want to go?
Left hand over right shoulder.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, ready?
Yeah. Okay, Lacey, your turn.
Give me.
I got you.
Oh.
Wait, left hand? Over right. Yeah, left hand over right shoulder. Woo! There's okay, vlog. We're at the Spanish Steps. How are you feeling?
We're going up the steps.
Yeah.
I'm actually kind of depressed because I really wanted to go to the Golden Gate Store.
Me too. But maybe that's a stop for Florence.
Yeah.
There's Carter and Richard. Oh.
Here we are on Spanish Steps. We're heading up.
Woo! Yeah. There's
Mr. Richard.
Yeah.
Richard is awesome.
Mr.
Yeah. So we're going up. We're really tired. How are you feeling, Carter? Are you tired?
I'm feeling definitely a little bit tired, but mainly just happy to be here.
Yeah, me too, me too.
It's like a real authentic Stairmaster.
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
Like
Lacey, how are you feeling?
I'm not loving the stairs.
Yeah.
I throw back to St. Mary's.
How are y'all feeling down here?
Fine.
Are y'all tired?
Yes.
Yes. The guys are always following behind. There we are. Bye, vlog. Porte casuna con un stemma rete, una cupulella che vi si era aizzata, passa scampaniando per tu l'età, con mano a papà da fa guardare. Tu fa l'americano, americano, americano, senta a me chi don fa fan. Vuoi vivere alla moda, ma se bevi whisky e soda, poi siete disturbato. Tu abballo rock e roll, tu gioca a pesa bolla,
Bei sorte beccamel. Chi te li dà la borsetta di mamma tua fa l'americana.
Hey vlog, we're at the Vatican. Here's a little aerial view with Marshall. Here we go. Basically, there's Marshall.
We're at that one place from Twilight.
How are you feeling today?
Really good. I'm having a great day. Well? I slept great.
How are you feeling today, Xander?
Good.
What about you, Ketcher? Okay. Basically, that's it. There he is. Everyone. There he is. Yeah! There he goes. Okay, guys, what's up?
Hey
guys, welcome back to our channel. Be sure to smash that like and subscribe. Absolutely demolished.
Yes.
And Tanner, how are you feeling?
I'm not consistent.
You're good?
Hey, it doesn't matter.
What's up, gang?
The ceiling's up. Oh, wait, don't run there.
No, the sky. It's actually the sky. Yeah, the Pope blessed us, actually.
And I need a water desperately.
Yeah, now you got one.
Yep.
We're all thirsty.
What anyone not paying attention?
They rejected the Holy
Spirit. Do a taste test.
Do a review.
Slight hit of Pringle, but like not as good.
Thank you.
Not as good as a Pringle? Taste it, Charlie. Is it good?
It's like if a basic chip's like a solid like 6 out of 10. It's like a 5.5/6.
Okay. This is our surrounding area. So actually, I want to try one.
Okay.
I'll take a real one. It just tastes like a Lay's. It's like the ones they have at... Oh, okay. Perfect. Okay. Back to my vlog point of view.
It's like regret.
Say bye.
Bye.
Now it's going. How's your day been going? How's their bread? It's really good.
Top tier.
Wow. New vlog. We're in ancient Rome. So there's How do you like ancient Rome? And we have not seen the Colosseum yet. And I'm kind of doubting it exists. Yep, there it is, y'all. Taken. Smile, Carter. There's Marshall.
Hold on.
There's the Colosseum.
Buonasera, signorina. Buonasera. Come bello stare a Napoli e sognare. Mentre in cielo sembra dire buonasera, la vecchia luna che sul Mediterraneo appare. Ogni giorno ci incontriamo camminando, dove pare che la montagna scenda in mare. Quante cose abbiamo detto sospirando, in quell'angolo più bello del mondo. Quante volte ho sussurrato amore e t'amo. Buonasera. Signorina,
vlog.
Hi, vlog.
Hi, vlog.
Hi. Hi. Vatican.
Say hey.
We just went to St. Peter's Basilica.
Absolutely demolished that.
We have this is us.
It's been a long day already.
Yeah, we already saw
it's all the Pope's tombs.
You're in America right now, and you're still up. Get some sleep.
Yeah,
so true.
Yeah, that's true.
So fact.
Bye, y'all. Peace out.
Walk, Carter.
Oh, we'll show a little foot.
You crazy. Foot on me.
This is our view.
This is
for the vlog. We can do it in like a fast motion, you know?
Yeah.
Some little...
Are you vlogging, Josie?
Yeah, I'm taking it all in. This is for the vlog. I'm going to put it together for our church presentation.
Ah. Did you do a presentation on this?
Yeah.
You're joking.
We get to tell the whole church
Marshall,
what we did.
Carter, did you do a presentation on this?
Yeah.
When?
Like in the fall. I feel like vlogging. Doing the vlog.
What do I do?
Hey, vlog. So this is what's happening in here. This is Jonathan supervising the guitar. How's it going, Stanton?
It's going egg-tastic.
Oh, yes, Corinne.
Yeah, pretty good.
Allie's doing a good job. Let's go into the kitchen. Sander, how's it going?
Very good.
The bread.
Bread. Bruschetta. Look at that.
Carter.
What's going on over there?
Is it good?
Yeah.
Michael, is it going well in?
I think so. I hope so.
How long did you think
the food was 10 out of 10? I ate lots of pasta.
How was yours?
It was great.
Corinne, how was yours?
It was pretty good.
Lacey?
Really good.
Yeah, was it fun? Smith,
yes,
how was yours?
It was really good.
Yeah, that was really fun. Vlog over. Vlogging.
It does kind of feel like a thing.
How was your catacomb experience?
10 out of 10 for catacombs.
It was really cool.
Actually, that was awesome.
Nice of weather down there.
Yeah.
We saw the tomb of St. Cecilia.
Yeah.
The Good Shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
We saw bones.
Alexandra.
It was cool. It was like we were in a cave.
Yeah. Marshall, how was your catacomb?
Okay, I didn't feel like violently claustrophobic.
Yeah.
So, like,
yeah.
I was fine.
I expected to be a lot more creeped out.
My leg did hurt.
Yeah.
And so, but I couldn't take pop a squat.
Because
it was dirt. And
pop a squat on
Yeah, she saw
Marvel.
Some very special Marvel.
She was the witness.
Thing to think about. It was a great day.
Great day. 10 out of 10.
Wow. Definitely.
How was your day, Richard?
10.
And did you like the catacombs?
I did. Catacombs were really cool.
Yeah.
I mean,
back on the bus.
Unbelievable.
Yeah,
also,
yeah.
Just, like, the fact that they built that is insane to me. I can't comprehend it.
It is hard to comprehend. Very.
You okay?
Hey, bus.
Yes,
hey.
I was fine. It wasn't as, like.
Close.
Honestly, I don't
say hey, guys.
Carter. We have a print.
Okay. We're at the thing, Trevi Fountain. There they are in their tank tops.
Well,
they look like they're in Panama City.
Yeah.
We're actually in Florida. Sander, how was dinner?
It was good. Hey. Mozzarella pizza.
Okay.
Drop it.
the way to Assisi. It's been a long bus ride so far.
Hey!
Hi!
How's y'all's bus ride going?
It's been fine.
How are y'all's bus rides going?
Corinne doesn't like our song. We're all having fun.
Are you excited? Hey. Michael,
excited for
please pull it up.
There's Harrison.
I'm vlogging, but it's like so
good. Say hi.
Hello.
Brand new rip just popped in.
Welcome to Assisi.
Hi.
Say hi. We're here.
Look at the beautiful view.
It's really pretty and it's very like Assisi, like what I was expecting. You know? See? We're getting lots of flicks because look at this view.
Yes.
Look at this. It's really good.
Very interesting here.
Yeah, we had a lot of meowing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
From Stanton.
I should like change my position.
But yeah.
And Michael.
Yeah, Michael's meowing. Look at these fat little pigeons. Look at them go.
Chubby little guys.
Yep, but we made it. What's up?
We're about to go into St. Francis Basilica.
Hey, we're about to look at one of the
Francis Basilica. Marshall's putting on her scarf because she didn't wear dress code.
Yes.
She's a baddie.
Weren't told about.
Massimo did not warn us. Oh, we have to wear masks. I can hear him saying that. There he is.
Why doesn't he tell us these?
Non è un mambo piemontese, ma hey mambo, no, non è tarantella, hey mambo, non voglio mozzarella, no, 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 mambo italiano, prova ad assaggiare.
Hey vlog, we're eating lunch, all girls.
Spaghetti carrettiere.
Oh, I told
you. Corinne got her. This is mine. It looks really good. There's Marshall's. Lacey got the same thing. Yes.
I got a filet.
Yes. Smith got a filet. Carter got her meat. Yep. Lunch. Where are we going, Marshall?
We're going to go to the new store.
Are we excited? We are. This is, I think, the Baptistery.
So beautiful.
There's the Prada.
It's not like anything we've seen so far, really.
Yeah.
Except for like the church, St. Paul's within the walls.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I think this is.
Where are we going?
Oh. Statue of David, it's not. It's not at least going.
It's going.
Oh. We're
gonna go now it is.
David.
Wait, we're leaving? Oh, goodness. Oh, we're on the move. Massimo's on a rush. In the vlog, it's really dark.
Hello.
We are on the roof currently.
Potrai posare sul bianco tuo velo quando sull'altare ti porterò questa piccolissima serenata con un fil di voce si può cantare.
susurrerà, la susurrerà.
We are last
day.
Yeah, we're in Florence. There's Carter and
the rest of our seven people are at the Lego store, which is it this way? Yeah. Marshy.
Is it? Oh,
yeah.
Right.
So basically, we had some fun.
Lunch. We went to church this morning.
But we lost four of our friends.
Allie, Lacey, Richard, and Jonathan all have COVID, aka COVID-19, aka not
traveling. Not good noob, yeah. So. So the rest of us made it out alive, and we're gonna go home tomorrow. But it's been a rough morning. We're trying to make the best of the rest of the trip.
And then the boys and Smith and Corinne are
the Lego store.
We had a really sweet pet cemetery.
Yeah.
And a really pretty garden, and we had a nice conversation with the
priest. We prayed.
Yeah.
You know. Just we love Florence.
We do.
We love it here. Okay, well, that's the news. Peace out, vlog. We're in the Lego store now. We just took pictures in this.
Get the biggest shindig.
But we just went into Jo Malone, sniffed like every single perfume, and walked out. Say hi.
Lego store.
Yay! Italian Lego store. Yes. Sound of Music vibes right now while I'm really zoomed in. Carter's Maria. We're all the kids. Sound of Music. See, the hills are alive
with the sun.
So basically, Stan got pet when he was meowing. Someone came and pet him, like another. Okay, guys, we've made it to the peak of our pilgrimage. The peak.
Yeah.
Here we go.
We're just gonna kind of start wrapping it up. We can play the end of it, but we are going to be having church in here this morning due to the weather. So. Right now, if we have until church starts at 10:30, so if you would either go refresh yourself, grab a cup of coffee, and then come back, or if you would like to stay back and maybe kind of help, those would be the two options. And then church will be at 10:30 in here. There will be chairs, great worship all around. So thank you all for supporting the pilgrimage, and thank you all. Y'all's great. Thank you so much.
Josie.